Dear students, after continuing our previous discussion on programming paradigms, we will today discuss about object-oriented programming paradigm. So I again want to show the same figure which we were discussing in the last three modules, and this is the fourth module on the same figure by explaining different programming paradigms. So we have discussed imperative paradigm, declarative paradigm, and functional paradigms. So today we will focus on object-oriented paradigm, and here we have the languages like C#, Java, C++, and similar languages. So what is object-oriented paradigm? It is associated with a programming language known as object-oriented programming language, or OOP. And software system is viewed as a collection of units called objects. So what are objects? Each object is capable of performing the actions that are immediately related to itself, as well as requesting actions of other objects, and together these objects interact to solve the problem at hand. So let's have an example. If you are going to develop a GUI, so all of the icons on a GUI will be implemented as objects in the object-oriented paradigm. So for example, on a GUI in a graphical user interface, you have buttons, you have text boxes, you have different icons. So all of them will be considered as objects. And each object will have its own methods, collection of functions called methods as well. So what would be the difference between a list, which we have discussed in many modules when we discuss sequential search algorithm, binary search algorithm? We have a list, and if that list is contained in an imperative paradigm and that list is contained in the object-oriented paradigm, what would be the difference? So in imperative paradigm, that list is contained as a list. And if you, for example, want to sort that list, you need to write your algorithm to sort that list. If you want to search within the list, you need to write an algorithm which searches that list. However, in the object-oriented paradigm, all functionality will be available along with the list of items of objects. And for example, searching, sorting. So all of such functionality in the form of methods will be available along with the list as a data structure. So that kind of basically place where you write all of such information, such description, this is called a class in object-oriented paradigm. So if we conclude today's module, we have learned about object-oriented paradigm, what are objects, and we have seen a practical example that what are the differences between list shown in the imperative paradigm and shown in the object-oriented paradigm, and what is the concept of class.